friends, and welcome. My name's Katie. I'm a wedding and portrait photographer here in the lovely state of North Carolina. And today, we're going to be talking about weddings. I know, crazy. More specifically, we're going to talk about how you can be a good wedding guest or how not to be a bad wedding guest. Before I planned my own wedding, I had no idea the amount of detail and commitment it took. And everything has a timeline, and if you don't get the RSVP cards in enough time, you can't give it to the final numbers and everything. You can't do the seating chart and everything tumbles down. So I'm gonna give you some tips and tricks. They're super simple, super easy on how not to be a bad wedding guest. So tip number one is RSVP by the due date. Whenever you get a wedding invitation, it's gonna come with a little card that says, please RSVP by da da da, whatever date, do it. A lot is riding on the final number of attendees. I really realized that when I was invited to weddings, but a lot is dependent on the RSVP, the seating chart, final numbers for the venue, or the caterer, because more often than not, and I don't think a lot of people know this, most wedding venues, you pay per person or per plate. So you need to know that final number pretty far in advance because you need to make sure you get that final attendee number to the venue for your final invoice. And for our wedding specifically, we needed to know how many children and how many adults were coming because there were two separate menus. With the age of technology, most of the time the RSVP is on their wedding website, so you don't even have to go to the mailbox. You can literally sit on your phone and do it. Or if it's not a website and you do have to go to the mailbox, more than likely it's in a pre-stamped, pre-addressed, labeled package that you just check boxes, put back in, and put in the mailbox. It's not that hard, is what I'm saying. So once you get it, just RSVP right there. That's a tip that my husband and I use now because we know how important it is. Anytime we get a wedding invitation, then we just go ahead and RSVP right then. So on the top of our minds, we won't forget and we don't have to worry, oh no, did we RSVP later? So just do it. Just do it. Tip number two. Don't RSVP yes and not show up. This irks me. Like I said before, and I cannot stress this enough, and I'm probably gonna say it multiple times in this video, you pay per person. You pay per person at most wedding venues, or for the caterer, like you pay per plate. It's not like you just pay a flat fee most cases, and if people come, they come. If they don't, they don't. No, like you have a number of people and you're paying per person. I can't stress that enough. So since you're paying per person for most wedding venues and or caterers, the average cost of a wedding guest is about $51 per guest or per plate. And it can range all the way up to $100+ per plate. So if you RSVP yes, the bride and groom or their parents or whoever are paying for you no matter if you show up. No matter what, if you show up or not. And at my wedding personally, we had 10+ people show up. I know it's at least 10 because a whole table didn't show up, okay? And we were paying about $80 per plate, which is kind of up there. So that means 10+ people, so 10 people didn't show up, we're paying $80 a plate. Math would say we just spent $800+ for people who didn't even show up. So we've spent $800+ for nothing. So don't be that guy. So not showing up to a wedding that you RSVP yes for can really cost the bride and groom a good sum of money. If you RSVP yes, you should do everything in your power to go. Disclaimer, okay, sometimes there are things out of your control. So if there's an emergency or your flight gets delayed or canceled or whatever, that's fine. Just communicate with the bride and groom. More often than not, they are gonna be totally understanding of your situation. But again, if you RSVP yes, please come. Tip number three is don't RSVP no and show up anyway. Again, I'm gonna say it, say it with me. You are paying per person at a venue. So let's say 150 people, that's how many are supposed to show up, and 160 show up. You are going to be charged those 10 extra people. So you're thinking, oh, well, that's better than, you know, costing them money. You know, I'm showing up, I'm gonna be there. But you don't realize you're totally gonna wreck the seating chart, which is a lot more complicated and complex and just a lot more work than I originally thought. Because you have to be mindful of sitting people know each other together, or, you know, sitting people who hate each other not together. So there's a lot that goes into it. And if you RSVP no, but you show up, that means you're not on the seating chart. So that means two things. Number one, you're gonna be seated with strangers, or you have the potential to be seated with strangers or people you don't know or people you don't like. You can't expect to have a seat for a place you did not RSVP to. Or secondly, and this happened to someone's wedding, they had to bring a whole table out to accommodate the extra guests. And that just crowds up the room. Sometimes you won't have a table setting. The person who had this happen to them, they invited a couple, so only two people, and they RSVP'd no, and then showed up with seven additional people. So they brought a total of nine people that they were not expecting at their wedding. So of course they had to bring out a whole table for them because they can't just, they didn't have space. Disclaimer, because we had somebody who's in the military at our wedding, didn't think he would be able to come, so we RSVP'd no, but he communicated with us. And then he said last minute, oh, I can come, like, is it okay if I come? And of course we said yes, because like a whole table canceled on us or whatever. So if you're in one of those situations, just text the bride or the groom or the family member, whoever, just let them know. Tip number four is, on average, people spend $50 for a wedding gift. Now I'm not saying this to try and get you to buy a high-priced item. I'm just saying this is more of an FYI, because I started going to weddings by myself in like college, and I had no idea how much to spend on a wedding gift. I'm pretty sure I cheaped out on a lot of weddings. So this is just a general rule of thumb. Obviously, I hate that I have so many disclaimers in this video, but disclaimer, if you can't afford a $50 wedding gift, then don't get one. I'm just saying as an FYI, I didn't know this, so now you get to know it as well too, also additionally. Speaking of registry, tip number five is stick to the registry. Why some people think that they know the bride and groom better than the bride and groom know themselves, and they just know that they need this thing that they didn't register for, they did not exclusively ask for, but they're like, you know what, I think I'm gonna buy them a set of bowls with their faces on them or something. Whenever my husband and I got married, the first five gifts we opened after the wedding were off registry, and we were like, we do not like this trend. And I'm not talking about just like a mixing bowl or like a frying pan that you don't really care what they look like. Generally, I'm talking bedding, I'm talking wall decor. I cannot stress this enough. Stick to the registry or gift cards or cash. The bride and groom have specifically selected things that they either really need or would really like to have, and it's like the easiest thing just to go on their registry. And even if they're registered on Amazon, you can just order their gift and get it sent to their house. You don't even have to wrap it or take it to the wedding. And if you don't know what to get them off of their registry, or you're too late and the only things left is like an espresso machine and you don't want to spend $200, then just get them a gift card either to a place that they've registered for. If it's not Amazon, definitely Amazon, or just give them cash. Stick to the registry. Tip number six is, plan to show up at least 15 minutes early to the ceremony or festivities. A lot of people say, oh, it doesn't matter because there's this grace period of the wedding never starts at 4 o'clock, like it says on the invitation. It really starts at 4:15, so it doesn't matter if I'm early or not. I'll just be on time. Don't do it. It's better to be early and find your seat and not disrupt any of the events that are going on, because there's nothing worse than if you get to a wedding late and you're trying to sneak in while the mother of the bride is walking down the aisle or being ushered down the aisle. It's just awkward. Traffic is a thing, and if you hit it, it sucks, but that's why you plan to be there 15 minutes early. Just do it. It makes it easier on everybody, and then you're not stressed out and you're not disrupting any of the events. Tip number seven is, take the wedding favors. Now, we all know that they're a little gift at the end. Sometimes it's a snack, sometimes it's bubbles, I don't know. Those are items that the bride and groom have already paid for, and they got it for you. So even if you don't want it, even if you don't like it, still take it. I cannot express to you how many wedding favors we had left over from our wedding, and I've heard it from other brides as well. These are gifts that they specifically bought for their guests, so just be courteous. Tip number eight is, stay off your phone as much as possible. Now, we all know the infamous, don't stick your phone in the aisle to capture the bride coming up the aisle and block the photographer. But what you need to know is, even like during the reception, during the best man maid of honor speeches, being on your phone just kind of looks disrespectful. As a photographer and you're walking around taking pictures of the reception and people are just like this on their phones, it just doesn't look as nice. It means you're not in the moment with the bride and groom and you're not participating in the wedding. You're not on the dance floor. You're not watching them cut cake. You're on your phone. And you can be on your phone any day, any week, all the time, forever. But put it down for the wedding and the reception as much as possible. And just participate in their big day and just share in that moment with them. Tip number 9 is stay to the end of the wedding if at all possible, especially if they're having a special send-off. Nothing is more sad than photographing a sparkler send-off or a bubble send-off and there's like 5 people at the end of this wedding. I'm sure you've been to a wedding where you've had to hold like 4 sparklers in each hand to make it look like that nice row of sparklers in the picture. There are emergencies. There are reasons why you can't stay the entire time, but if it's up to you, stay the whole time. Again, it's not about you. It's about the bride and groom. It's about the couple who just got married. You're sharing in that experience with them. You get to be a part of their big day. Like, dance your heart out, stay to the end, do the bubbles, throw petals, whatever that they're trying to do. Just stay to the end of the wedding. And the last tip, tip number 10, don't complain. If you hear nothing from this whole video, hear me. Do not complain. At the wedding, after the wedding, before the wedding, do not complain about the wedding at all. Because it's not about you. It's not your wedding. And just because you wouldn't have pork at your wedding doesn't mean they don't just freaking love pork and want it at theirs. Like, it's their wedding. They think it's the greatest thing possible. The stereotype is a lot of, you know, your great aunt, you just can never make her happy. She's just gonna complain that the food's dry and the music's loud, but that's not always the case. I've been in weddings where the young people are complaining, especially if there's no alcohol. If you want to make a young person complain at a wedding, do not serve them alcohol because they will certainly complain. If you're complaining that there is either no alcohol at this wedding or that you have to pay for your alcohol at this wedding, maybe, just maybe, the bride and groom didn't want to shell out a couple grand so you can get hammered at their wedding. You're going to a wedding to share in the love of 2 people you know. You get to share in their love and be a part of their special day. I know I've said that probably a lot through this video, but you know, it's not about you, it's about them. It's their wedding, it's their dream, it's, you know, they planned it, they did it all. And nothing makes a bride self-conscious than people coming up and complaining to her about something. Somebody came up to me on my wedding and told me they didn't like the chicken. One thing to always remember is you're at a free party. You're at a free party, you get a free dinner, or at least free appetizers, you get free cake or whatever other dessert, and you get a free wedding favor gift at the end. Like, you definitely have the better end of the deal, other than like them getting married and spending eternity in happiness. Just don't complain. It's not about you, it's about them, it's their wedding day. Don't dampen the mood with your complaining, okay? Okay? I hope you like this video. I hope you find these tips useful. I know that they're super simple and super easy, but I really hope you follow them because it'll make everybody's lives easier who's planning this wedding. If you like this video, you can hit subscribe, and I post new videos every Thursday. I'll see you next time. Bye!